class 801 electric multiple units are operated by London North Eastern Railway under the Azuma brand, and were brought into service in 2019 under the Intercity Express programme. Today, I'm taking a ride on one of LNER's Azuma services to give you a brief insight into the rolling stock. These units were introduced as part of the Department for Transport's aforementioned Intercity Express programme, which saw Hitachi's AT300 trains succeed the ageing Intercity 125 and Intercity 225 fleets on the East Coast Mainline and Great Western Mainline. They were initially being manufactured for both London North Eastern Railway and Great Western Railway. However, in 2016, GWR announced that they would update their order to Class 800 Mark III units for bimodal operation. This was due to delays in the electrification of the Great Western Mainline, and the Class 801s only being fitted with a single diesel engine for emergency use only. LNER is operating 12 5-car Mark I units and a further 30 9-car Mark II units. These first entered service with doubled up Mark 1s on the 16th of September in 2019, and later that year, the 9-car units were introduced on the 18th of November. Alongside the Class 801s, LNER also operates 23 Class 800 BMUs. In standard class, there is a 2+2 seating configuration, with a variety of single and table seats in each coach. On the backs of single seats are relatively compact fold-down tables, and there are also foldable armrests. Plenty of space to store luggage can be found at the ends of each coach, with more space both under and above your seat. Electronic seat reservation is also utilised, with displays above each seat. Power sockets can be found between each pair of seats for laptops and phones, and where available, there is also food and drink service which is delivered directly to your seat. There are wheelchair spaces and accessible toilets and boards as well, should you need them. First class offers a variety of enhancements, including access to LNER first class lounges, though the value of these upgrades is obviously subjective. Following the rollout of the Class 800 BMUs and the Class 801 EMUs, further orders for AT300 units have been placed by various train operating companies in the UK, although these are not under the Intercity Express programme. Great Western Railway have since ordered several additional units for their IET fleet, and whole trains are now operating Class 802 Paragon units. TransPennine Express have also taken interest in the Class 802s, and these are now in service under the Nova Fleet Overhaul. Furthermore, East Midlands Railway and Avanti West Coast both announced orders for various AT300 trains in 2019. And if that wasn't enough for you, the recently unveiled budget operator Lumo will be operating 5-car Class 803s for its open access service beginning October 2021. As yet another subsidiary of First Group, this TOC will be running 2 trains per day in either direction to offer a budget service from London to Edinburgh. It's certainly an interesting strategy, and one that can be likened to many budget airlines, but with limited capacity, I'm going to have to wait to see how things pan out. However, if Lumo does turn out to be a relative success, we might see them expanding to the West Coast Mainline, for example. Now, I often see IETs taking an immense amount of criticism from rail enthusiasts, and the conversation comparing IETs to their predecessors amasses plenty of debate. And so, if you want to hear my opinion, I think they're just okay. The reality is, these trains are not being designed for rail enthusiasts like you and I, and they shouldn't be. With the concern surrounding cracks discovered in Hitachi trains aside, the IETs do just what they're supposed to do most of the time. The Intercity 125 fleet was in dire need of a complete overhaul, and have been succeeded by trains that, no, they don't have all these extras a train enthusiast might appreciate, but they do actually get people to where they need to be. So, what are your thoughts on LNER's Azuma fleet? Or rather, any of the other IET/AT300 trains you've seen or travelled on? How would you compare them to their predecessors? Let me know in the comments below. I've been Seb, and thank you for watching To The Trains.